All right, welcome to the Firebase basics tutorial. In this tutorial, we're gonna implement a very simple GIF sharing application. As you can see right now, I have a home page, a profile page, and a login page. I've already configured my Firebase config. Make sure you check out our Getting Started with Firebase video on YouTube. Here to set up your Firebase properly. All right, so what is gonna be the structure, the schema of our app? We'll just have a very simple users collection, which has all the users in the app, and then we'll have all the different posts, and they're gonna show up here in the feed, and then on the profile picture. Hopefully you can also see all the GIFs you've shared. Cool. I'm gonna go to Firestore here. I had a test collection. So let's first create the users collection. And one thing I'll do here is check create user record and set the collection to users. What this does is make sure that every time a user signs up in our app here, every time a user signs up, will automatically create a user's record in Firestore. So the way Firestore works, you know, there's authentication. I've already created an account here, so you can see I've logged in. Here, every time a user creates an account, it doesn't mean that a Firestore record will be created for them. So actually, I haven't So if you look at the Firestore, I didn't even create my Firestore database end, but I was still able to authenticate. So authentication and Firestore are two different things. So by checking this box, it allows you to create a user record every time a user signs up. And we'll automatically populate these fields for you, which means when the user signs up, if we will grab the email, display name, photo URL, all this stuff, and automatically set it to the correct value. So right now I don't have any collections. However, if I delete this account now, come in here, I've already marked this as a checkbox. So if I push this, I've already set up my project with GitHub, so I can quickly test it locally. One thing I'll mention is if you do preview, none of this stuff in preview actually is connected to Firebase. So we warn you here, Firestore data is not loaded from Firebase. So if you do sign up, it'll just show fake a login. It is not actually hitting your Firebase. So I have to run it locally, and I'm gonna do that now. Okay. So here we are. I'm gonna go to Firestore so you can see the record being created live. I'll enter credentials here, sign up. If everything is working properly, you should see the record being created here. And let's see, we have the authentication. There we go. Yes, so user record is created. I have my UID and the created time set. Display name and photo URL, all of the stuff that you see here will show up if the provider has it. That's more authentication. If you're using like a Google sign-in or Facebook sign-in, it will have photo URL and display name set. Cool. So we were able to log in and have the user record being populated. Cool. Now, one thing we'll add is the posts collection. So one thing you have to be careful about when you're creating these collections here in FlutterFlow is that it has to match what you see here in Firestore exactly. So in this case, we have the user collection, and you can think of collections almost as like a single sheet in a spreadsheet. And it will have a bunch of different values, like the it will have a different bunch of different documents, and each document is almost like a row in this spreadsheet, and each value here is almost like a column. So created time, email, UID. These should be the same for all of the different users, and this also has to match the keys of these different fields: email, UID, created time. They have to match exactly to what you define here. And right now we don't have a way of parsing that in, so you have to manually come in and define the fields. So for posts, what we'll have is a URL. So there's going to be like a GIF URL. This will be an image path. It's just a single element. That's actually optional. And we also have a user who uploaded this post. So for that, the way you do that is by selecting record reference when you're selecting the type of the field. And for reference type, we will say users. So now this is what we're going to use to represent all of the different posts that we have. And let's actually, you know, just to show you how this works, create the collection manually here. Let's call it post. Let's add some fake data here, posts. We'll just auto ID for the document ID. This is just an example data I'm adding. So we need GIF URL, as you can see here. I'll set the GIF URL to, let's go to Giphy and get a cat GIF, because, you know, cat GIFs are fun. There we go. Save. So we have the GIF URL. We also need to add user here. And this is going to be a reference. In this case, we'll just, I'll copy this user's reference. Add field user. Reference add. So I have some test data here of a single post that's made by my user account. And ideally, now here on the feed in the home page, we want all of the posts here to show up in this list view. So you can see the structure of our app right now in the widget tree. We have a list view which contains column here, and that has a card, it has an image and some text. So we want this to be the email and this to be the GIF. Cool. So how do you do that? How do you get a collection to show up here? It's easy. This works on all kind of repeated elements like row, column, list view, grid view. You can always select this create backend request icon here, this data icon on a list view, unless you query a collection. So we'll say, yes, we want this to come from the post. We want all of these different values to be posts. And you know what? Let's add a created time so we can sort the posts by, so we can show the latest one first. So we'll add a created timestamp field here. So yeah, query collection posts order by created at decreasing. So it shows you the most recent stuff first. Let's save that. Gives us a warning that this is going to be dynamically generated now. That sounds okay. Cool. Maybe you add a little bit of spacing between the elements here. So what it's doing now is it's basically taking the first child of this list view, this card, and repeating that card for every value in our collection here for posts. So if we had 100 posts here, there are going to be 100 different values showing up down here. So whatever you're doing to this card, if I modify this, add and increase the padding, it's going to apply everywhere, right? So I'm going to actually give this a little bit of more spacing here for this card on the bottom. So there's a little bit of space between the different posts. Yeah, that looks fine. All right, now, but we don't want this same image to be repeated, right? We want this to actually be the image here, this GIF URL. We also need a created app. Might as well add this now. Timestamp. We'll just pick today, doesn't matter. So we want GIF URL in to show up here. Yeah, so let's do, the way you do that is by selecting the image path here, set from variable, select post record. Now this is coming from the list view, right? The list view has a query. So you can select the post at this for one of these elements, and you can select the GIF URL. Now that means when you run this, it will actually use the GIF from Firestore. Let's see if that works. I'm going to push to GitHub and run it locally. It should automatically log me in because I was already logged in earlier. All right, there we go. So there we have it. So we only have one post here. And that's because in Firestore, we only have one post. Now, if I add a document here, let me copy this GIF URL again. If I add a document, auto ID, GIF URL, paste. If I paste it again, you should see the second document appearing here shortly. It also needs the created app field. That makes sense. Okay, cool. There you have it. So that's how you actually connect images to come from Firestore. Now, what if we wanted this email to show up here? Now, the thing is, we don't actually have the email here. We only have the user reference. The email is in the user's collection. So one way to make it happen is to come in here and also add an email option here for posts. But there is a way from the UI builder here itself to actually get the value to show up here. And the way you do that is I could select this card here and say, I want this to get a document from a reference. And I'm going to select get the user's document and get it from, so get a user's document, right? Like we want to get the user's email, whoever posted it. So we need to query the user's collection, and I want the record to come from the post record user reference. Now that's kind of tricky. Let me kind of go through that again. A post has a user reference, right? So the way Firestore works, you can refer to another document by just using the whole path slash user slash the doc ID, you know, which is here. This is the path. So this post is made by this user. Now, if you want to load that user document, the way you do it in FlutterFlow is you can say, I want to get a document from reference, and I want it to be a user document and get it from the post's user. As soon as I hit save now, basically anything underneath this card will have access to that user object. So let me show you here. You can select this janedoe@gmail.com, set from variable, get it from the user's record, and get the email value. Hit save. Now, if I run this, you'll actually see the email showing up. Let me push the GitHub and show you that working. Okay, it's ready. Gonna pull here and run it. All right. We should have the email showing up here. Yep, there we go. So we have the post, loads the user record here, and the email shows up. So now if I show you live, if I modify the email in the user object, you'll see it changing here. Test. Yeah, so this is the way Firestore works. It actually is doing a real-time synchronized read. So if there's any updates, it will actually immediately update. This is very fast, as you can see. Well, that's the Firestore basics tutorial. Make sure to check out the advanced tutorial to see more of the features we have for you.